Hello students, in the previous class we have discussed about the vitamins. So today let us discuss about nucleic acid. So generally nucleic acids are generally what here? So these are biologically significant polymers of nucleotides with polyphosphate ester chain. So means what here? Nucleotides. So nucleotide means we are going to have purine and pyrimidine structures. So those are called, we call it as nucleotides. With what we are going to have polyphosphate ester chain. So polyphosphate ester chain is nothing but phosphate group you are going to have, and also ester is nothing but COO group you are going to have. Okay, so that one we call it as ester chain. So by this what we can say here? Nucleic acids. So nucleic acids are biologically significant polymers of nucleotides with polyphosphate ester chain. So this one we call it as what here? Nucleic acids. So what is nucleic acids? So these are biologically significant polymers of nucleotides with polyphosphate ester chain. We call it as nucleic acids. So these all are present in. So polymers. So nucleotides means we are going to contain here purine and pyrimidine structures. Polyphosphate means compulsory phosphate ring is going to have, and also C double bond O group we are going to have, which are linked to those groups. That one we call it as nucleic acids. So these are present in all living systems. So these are present in all living cells. Okay, so here they can directly prepare the proteins, and also they form the genetic information. So the proteins, whatever it is forming by direct synthesis of proteins, what we can say, they are the transferring genetic information. That one we call it as hereditary. So what we can say here, they direct the synthesis of proteins and are responsible for the transfer of genetic information so genetic information, that is what here we call it as hereditary. Okay, so coming to here, nuclear proteins. So how the nuclear proteins are going to form when combining with nucleic acid and proteins, that one will give the nuclear proteins. So nuclear proteins, how it is formed? Nuclear proteins so are formed by combining proteins with nucleic acids. We call it as nuclear proteins. Okay, so here what we can say here, nuclear proteins is equals to, how the nuclear proteins is going to form here is equals to proteins. Nucleic acids is nothing but here nucleic acids, purine and pyrimidine bases, we call it as nucleic acids here. So here these are polyamide chains. These proteins, whatever it is forming proteins, polyamide. Amide is nothing but what? C double bond by NH2. So it can have more amide chains. So by this what we can say here? Proteins have polyamide chains. And also the repeating unit of, so whenever the nucleic acid is repeating, so the repeating unit of nucleic acids we call it as here nucleic acids are called nucleotides. So what is nucleotides? Whenever the nucleic acid unit is repeating, that one we call it as what here? Nucleotides. So generally here we are going to have the nucleotides. Nucleotides is also known as two types nucleic acids. So it consists of two types. One is RNA. So RNA is nothing but what here? Ribonucleic acid. DNA is nothing but what here? Deoxyribonucleic acid. Okay, so these are the two types. It consists of the nucleotides. So here when you do hydrolysis of DNA and RNA, so they form deoxyribose or ribose, a pentose, heterocyclic nitrogenous base, and also phosphoric acid. So means what it is going to present here, when you do hydrolysis of DNA and RNA, RNA gives finally deoxyribose or ribose, a pentose, heterocyclic nitrogenous base, and phosphoric acid. Heterocyclic nitrogenous base and phosphoric acid. So this is nothing but DNA RNA. Okay, so means what here? Deoxyribose we are having, ribose. So when you do hydrolysis, what happened? DNA means what? Deoxyribonucleic acid. RNA means ribonucleic acid. So these two will give a pentose, 5-membered ring structure, and also heterocyclic nitrogenous base. So heterocyclic compound it is going to give, and also it is going to give phosphoric acid when you do hydrolysis. So here, when you, what I have told you here, two types it is going to present. What is that means here? Okay, so when you take here, like carbohydrates, it is going to form CH2, OH, OHH, HOH, HOH. So this is the pentose when we do hydrolysis. So coming to here, here also CH2OH, H, HOH, here both sides H, OH, H. So this one we call it as beta D ribose present in RNA. So this one we call it as beta D deoxyribose. So present in what here? DNA. So when you do hydrolysis, these two. So what I have told you, pentose it is forming. So next what I have told you here, it is forming nitrogenous bases. So nitrogenous bases is nothing but it is going to give purine bases and also pyrimidine bases. So purine and pyrimidine bases is nothing but here. So when you take this one, so this one we call it as pyrimidine. So this is going to three types of compound. So first one is uracil, C double bond O, NH, CH double bond, CH, NH, C double bond O. So this one we call it as uracil. This is the one compound it is giving. So next one it is going to give cytosine. So here C NH2, double bond N, CH, double bond, CH, NH, C double bond. Okay, so this is the name, cytosine. And one more thing we are going to get here is thiamine, that is C double bond O, NH, C double bond, CH3, CH, NH, C double bond. Okay, so this is the compound it is giving. So this one we call it as thiamine. So this is nothing but pyrimidine bases. When you do hydrolysis, uracil it is giving cytosine. So we write it as a single letter, that is C U T. So thiamine, cytosine, uracil. Okay, so next one, if you take purine bases, if you take here, it consists of purine also, same thing. So this is attached to 5 member ring, that is NH. So here you are going to have this one, we call it as purine. So this purine is consist of adenine and also guanine. So here going to get here C double bond C, here C, NH2, N, CH, N double bond, CH, NH. Okay, so this is consisting of adenine, that is A. Okay, so this purine is going to give adenine and also guanine. So means what here? C double bond O, NH, C double bond C, N double bond C, NH2. Okay, so this consists of what here? N double bond CH, NH. So means what? This one is giving guanine, that is G. So these are the heterocyclic nitrogenous bases. So means what here? It is giving pentose, and also it is giving, when you do hydrolysis, these two, this pyrimidine and this purine, when you take, so these two consist of heterocyclic nitrogenous bases. So when you do hydrolysis, automatically what happens, it is giving uracil, thiamine, cytosine for pyrimidine. So when you take purine, it is giving adenine, here it is giving guanine. So okay, so this is about, so when you take, there are two types of nitrogen bases, that is what here, that is, it consists of purine derivative and pyrimidine derivatives. Purine derivatives is consisting of what here? Purine derivatives is consisting of adenine and guanine, that is A and G. Pyrimidine derivatives consisting of uracil, thiamine, cytosine. Okay, so when you take these IUPAC names here, so this uracil consists of what here? 2,4 dioxo pyrimidine, we can say. So coming to cytosine, we can say here 4 amino 2 oxo pyrimidine. Coming to thiamine, we can say 5-methyl 2,4 dioxo pyrimidine. Okay, coming to adenine, we are going to have 6 amino purine. Here 2 amino 6 oxo purine. So these are the IUPAC names. It is going to consisting of, so those are general names, these are IUPAC names. So coming to here, DNA. So DNA consists of here, DNA is containing pairs of A, Z, C, T. So A, G, C, and T. Adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine. Coming to RNA, it consists of A, Z, C, and U. In place of T, we are writing uracil. Okay. So here, pentose sugar. Pentose sugar means what? Here, the nucleic acid having beta D ribose. That one we call it as pentose, and beta D deoxyribose DNA. So these are the general introduction of the nucleic acids. In the next class, we can discuss about the nucleosides and nucleotides and structure of DNA, RNA also. Thank you.